guys, and welcome back to my channel. So it is Christmas Eve and I'm super excited. My hairdresser just messaged me and said that I can come anytime now to the salon. So I'm gonna go get my hair done. I put oil in it in the night before and just like massaged it. And so it's time to like wash out all the oils. You know the drill if you've watched my other hair salon videos. Then when I'm done, I'm going to be coming back here to get ready for the light show, which I'm so excited for. And I've just seen really good reviews like on TikTok and stuff about it. So my brows, yeah, they're still really dark. I'm just waiting for them to peel. This is the thing about microblading, like you have to wait for it to like peel off and for the color to fade to see like the actual results. And like, I'm impatient. I'm like, I need the results now. I will see you guys at the hair salon. You guys, look, they've decorated for Christmas. Christmas is tomorrow. It's gonna look so good at night. Even the salon has like decorated. Cute. Christmas can become a really hectic and chaotic day for many people, so it's really important that you take some time out for yourself and don't forget to slow down and just really enjoy this time with family and friends and some self-care. So I did my usual routine whenever I come to the salon, but today I got a haircut. I rarely ever get haircuts because I hate doing it, but it was really important and I'm happy I did it. So my hair is officially done. I'm gonna show you guys how festive Egypt is during the holiday season. How cute is this? So I'm back. I went to Starbucks and they, I guess, were sold out or they didn't have any more toffee nut latte. So I was really bummed out about that. So then I went next door and I was like, you know what? I should just order my pancakes and tell them to package it. And the man said they did not have any more pancakes. What? So I was like really sad about it. So then I just came home and I ordered a toffee nut latte to the house because there's other Starbucks that probably still have it. So that's what I did. So now I'm home. I'm about to turn on my fireplace. Let me show you what I mean by that. All right, you guys. So if you don't have an Amazon Fire Stick, this honestly is like game changing. A little device and you connect it to your television. You basically have access to like all of your favorite things. So for example, Prime Video, Netflix, Crave, YouTube, CTV, go to YouTube. And you basically connect this little device, the Amazon Fire Stick, to your home Wi-Fi. And honestly, I bring this with me everywhere. And when I say everywhere, I mean like hotel rooms. I just connect. And then that way I can watch like my favorite things while I'm in a hotel room or like other places. I love it. Okay, so I'm getting the one that's just the fire crackling. It would be nice if I could play music, but the way YouTube is set up. Okay, so I have to leave here at 4:30 to go see the ice show. I'm thinking I should just like do my makeup, get ready, wait for my Starbucks and food to come, and just like have a chit chat with you guys. What do you guys think? Okay, shout out to Abba and Preach. Wait, where's my remote? So now I am on my way to the ice show. I'm really excited. Tell me if you're gonna spot Jamaica in about 3, 2, 1. Oh, what's up, Jamaica? The light installations and the rollout of the red carpet was absolutely stunning at this event and definitely IG worthy. I mean, look at this red carpet. They went all out for this event. The
the ice show was absolutely amazing. It was really entertaining. They had lots of talented ice skaters and dancers. And one thing I really liked about the show was that they were super interactive with the crowd. I really enjoyed the show. Overall, I had a really good time on Christmas Eve watching the show and seeing all the cool tricks that they were doing on stage for the audience, and it was a great way to end my Christmas Eve.
What's up, you guys? It is Christmas morning and I'm going to be putting my table together. I'm going to be making a fruit platter in the shape of a Christmas tree, and I'll show you my inspiration. There we go. That's what I'm aiming for. Let's see if it turns out cute. And then after that, I'm going to be making my garlic noodles with shrimp and mussels pasta. It's going to be a little spicy. Like, ooh, I haven't had this in, I want to say, at least 6 months. So I'm really excited to make this dish and share it with you guys.
I am super excited to be making this Christmas tree fruit platter. So we're going to need some pineapples, strawberries, and some cantaloupe. So I'm going to start off with one pineapple facing upwards to represent the star on our Christmas tree. So next I am adding in my grapes, but I'm doing it by rows. So my first row, I'm going to add one grape. Second row, I'm going to add maybe three or four grapes. And then I'm just going to continue and make a little pyramid or like a triangle. So next, I am adding some delicious strawberries, and so I'm facing the strawberries in a certain direction. So the pointy side, I'm having them all face towards my left-hand side, and I'm making about two rows, and then I'm putting some strawberries on top to layer the rows. I'm just like squishing it all together to make it fit nicely. This is me being excited that I'm doing it right. So next I'm adding my cantaloupes, and I absolutely love cantaloupes, so I'm happy I got these, and I'm just making two rows with them. And now I'm adding the pineapples to give it another pop of color to the tree. And now I'm just adding the last layers of grapes to complete our fruit platter tree.
You guys, look what I did! Honestly, I think it's really cute and I'm really proud of myself. I remove maybe a row of these grapes, but I'm proud. I got a gift! I don't know if you guys can see. This gift is from my dear friend Sharuk and her husband Abdulrahman, and look what they got me, you guys. It's this super cozy knit blanket. I love it. Shukran, thank you guys so much. This isn't even the best part of what they got me. This video is sponsored by Sharuk and Abdel, because I had no pots or pans. I don't really cook, I'm just gonna keep it real. Sharuk and Abdel have sponsored this video and have provided me with some pots and some pans so I can make the garlic noodles, shrimp noodles. So shout out to you, Sharuk. Shout out to you, Abdel. I really appreciate you guys. You guys are the best. Okay, you guys, so we're in the kitchen, and I'm not gonna lie to you, I'm stressed. Just so nervous because this is a gas, like, see that? That's the gas that turns this thing on, and like, you guys, I'm not trying to be homeless on Christmas. I can't believe I'm doing this. But I bought the items. You know what? If all else fails, I have a beautiful fruit platter out there. In the shape of a Christmas tree. I'm good. Okay, so in order to not make this video super, super long, and sorry for the noise in the background, it's the fridge. It's a whole other story. I'm just going to show you how I make this meal. I'll probably do a voiceover, and I'll also put the link of the girl's channel who actually introduced me to how to make this dish.
So I really love my super green pasta. It's made of vegetables and it literally tastes just like pasta. So if you notice, the oven is not on this entire time, and I'll be addressing that in 3, 2, 1.
LOL. So I don't remember how to turn this on. So I'm gonna have to figure that out. You know what? We're strong. We got this. Oh my God, I'm so nervous. I don't want any problems. I want no problems. One. I need a lifeline. 1 second. Oh my gosh, you guys. I think I have to plug the oven in. Do you have to plug ovens in? Is that a thing? I'm so nervous. Let's see if this makes a difference. Ah! You guys, I did it. I had to plug the oven on. I had to plug it in. You guys, this is a Christmas miracle.
Alright, so now it's time to make our sauce. So you're gonna need some red hot chili flakes, some sriracha sauce, minced garlic, honey, and oyster sauce. So at this point, I'm just really exhausted and I'm not following the recipe as exact, but I will be linking it down below. I just know that all of these ingredients have to end up inside this bowl and I'm not really measuring, I'm just like feeling it out, and I'm just gonna wait until my African ancestors tell me that's enough, my child. And yeah, so we shall continue.
Hey guys, so this is what it looks like once you put everything together. Sorry, I ran out of storage and had to delete stuff, and then I wanted to finish cooking because I'm getting hungry. I tasted the shrimp and it tastes so good. It's exactly what I envisioned for myself on Christmas, is just to have like my fruit platter, my green pasta. I'm gonna add some more chili flakes on top because I like it spicy. I put the extra shrimp in this container. I'm so excited and I'm so happy. Look at this, you guys. Honestly, this was hard work, but I'm really happy. And now I can enjoy my green pasta. Merry Christmas and thank you guys so much for watching. If there's anything that I did today, it was that and that. You guys, my mussels are ready. So basically I just added the mussels to the sauce that I made prior, and I added a little vegetable, you know that cube thing? Like a vegetable like flavor. I added that cube thing to the pot. And so one of my mussels is ready. I usually have this with the pasta, but I was so hungry, you guys. And like behind the scenes, I went through a lot. I went through a lot. Okay, so this is ready. And I can tell that it's ready because it has like a bit of color to it. It's not as like pale as before. And I just take it out and I eat it like so. Merry Christmas!